solved two problems.
What page?
Section 9.8, right?
I was a math person for calculus, man. Math analysis, I did in my sleep.
Okay, oh, this is going to be long, I think.
Oh my god.
Awesome.
We're not gonna do that.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's begin. What do you do with cotangent squared x, cosecant x? Are they related?
Cosecant cotangent.
Are they related?
Cosecant plus minus.
You can do cosecant cotangent, but then the remaining function will be cotangent x. Does that help us?
Cotangent is
It's cosecant squared, right?
Okay, so you have to do the other way.
You have to do the other way of doing it, which is rather than having cotangent, what can we do?
Cosecant squared plus minus 1.
We can use the cosecant squared minus 1, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so cosecant squared x minus 1, cosecant x.
And then distribute it.
Then you distribute it,
so you get cosecant
and you get cosecant cubed x minus cosecant x dx. And then separate them so that we see what we can do. Can we do anything?
We can find
the answer to this right away, right? That's what? I think it's going to be what?
Like ln tangent plus
ln of the absolute value of cosecant x minus cotangent x plus c. Is it negative ln or plus?
Positive.
So it's this, right? So this is good, right?
Yeah.
Now this one.
Hold on.
That's.
No, you're good. It's positive.
Yeah, this one, what do we do here?
Do it again. Make it cosecant squared x.
Make it cosecant squared x and
cosecant
x.
And make it again.
Okay, so that will be cosecant squared x. Cosecant x dx.
Do it again.
Cotangent plus. Oh yes.
I don't think you want to do cotangent. You don't want to go back to cotangent.
Yeah.
Okay, because the derivative of cotangent is cosecant squared.
Yeah.
And you won't have it, correct? Instead, what do you do? What am I going to write?
Integration
by
parts.
Okay.
Okay.
So let's look at our integral. So integral of cosecant squared x cosecant x dx, right? So what is our u and what's our vv?
Cosecant.
The u is cosecant x, right? And the vv is cosecant squared x dx. And we can differentiate this, get the differential, it's negative cosecant x cotangent x. And the v here is what? What's the integral of cosecant squared?
Negative
cotangent, right? Negative cotangent x. Okay, very good. So therefore we have this is equal to uv, which is negative cosecant x cotangent x, right? Minus the integral of vdu, this two, right? Okay?
So like this.
So help me, I can't see. Is it cosecant x cosecant squared x? Did I copy it right?
Yes.
Dx. Oh, see, I was telling you were sloppy. I am sloppy
dx.
Here too. I forgot my dx. Okay.
Oh my God.
So put the dx, right? Okay. So are we good here? Do you see what you can do there? It looks like we went back, right?
Yeah.
Oh, can you like?
No. Oh,
you can add it to the other side.
Add
it to the other side and then divide it by two.
Yeah, divide by two.
No. But this is not quite it yet, right?
No.
Yeah, but you have to, like.
It's the original problem, but remember the original already had. This is part of the answer is cosecant cubed x. I think we should just go back and write it as cosecant x, cosecant squared x minus 1.
Yeah,
right?
Plug it in.
So it's cosecant cubed minus cosecant x.
This is the one that you were excited about, that it's the same as this one, right?
Yes. You can have.
And then here you'll have a what? A plus.
Huh?
Is it a plus? I can't see. Integral of cosecant of x dx.
Okay?
Wait. Whoa.
Yeah.
That became that, so then you.
I'm not sure about this one, I'm just.
Then you add that cosine.
You can do it either.
Oh, then you broke it up.
Okay, are you okay?
Yes, but are you done?
Ablation, you mean?
You know.
No, no, we're not done, so then this will be, so then this will be this, this one you can move over here, right?
Yes.
So you have two integral of cosecant cubed x dx.
No, but it's negative cosec, yes.
Correct? Is equal to negative cosecant x cotangent x. Now what is the integral of cosecant x dx? We saw that already. Is ln of cosecant x minus cotangent x, right?
Yes.
So therefore, you divide by two and you get the answer for the integral of cosecant cubed x.
This is my kind of problem.
Okay? So let's go back to the original problem. So the original problem was integral of this.
See, this is fair.
Huh?
I like this problem. It's fair.
It's okay, right? And then you just have to.
And then you can only give us two more problems. This problem is taking.
So this will be half of this, right?
It's
half
fair,
of negative cosecant x cotangent x plus ln of cosecant x minus cotangent x. Correct? And then we had that other guy there, minus ln of cosecant x minus cotangent x plus c. Of course, we can still clean this up, right? Because these two are the same.
Well, you can't, so it's a half.
Can we leave that, right? Well, there's a plus half minus one.
So it's minus half.
So it will be a minus a half. I don't need
but
to write that right
But if you do it like
now.
That, you're going to get points on the exam.
Why do you ask about points on the exam?
Because that's all.
I told you it's not important. It's about enjoying the problem, right?
You see us all A's at the end of the semester?
If we start enjoying a little more, we'll be like,
so this is the final answer, right? Okay? Actually, oh well, no. That's it. There's nothing to do with this, right?
No.
Our original variable was x, so we're done. This is our
answer.
Okay. Yeah, don't ask me anything about points.
Okay?